which we are working on a regular manner. So I think that this also has an effect on the way in which we keep our housekeeping items. So with this, we'll just start our PPT presentation. I'll just share this screen with this PowerPoint. So, I myself am at Kundakal Division of South Central Railway. So, I have been working here for the past 2 years, and before that I was in stores and other places. On some other railways also I have worked. So, because of my experience in all these things, I'll just share with you a few things also, how these things actually work out. So, what is a suspense head actually? This is actually a head in which, by the name itself, you can understand that suspense. What is suspense? Suspense is something which you don't know. That's the main idea. Suspense is something which you do not know. Or you may know at a later period of time or date. So that is only suspense. If you know everything, there is nothing like a suspense. Like a movie thriller, in which we keep on guessing what happens in the end. So ultimately, you come to know the end. So it's a suspense thing. Okay, so till you do not know, it is a suspense. After you know, there is nothing like a suspense. So all of us should understand that suspense by name itself, is life is very small. Even when you go to a movie, you will understand that the suspense will remain only for a small brief period of time. So after that, the suspense is cleared. So in the same way, the suspense heads are also a brief period of time activity or accounting methods or system in which we keep or account certain transactions. Okay, so it is only an adjustment head. That means for a small time period of time, we will keep adjusting certain accounts and keep them in certain heads of account called suspense heads. So it is just like, you know, parking our car in a shopping mall, parking our bike in a shopping mall. This will be for a small time. After that, you have to remove your parking. Okay. So this is a amount or transaction which is parked in suspense head for a small time. So this is period of suspense accounts is life is very less. That we have to very clearly understand. So these are accounts operated in government accounts to both government accounts can be both receipts and payments. So we'll have a suspense head in receipts as well as in payments. Okay, and because we do not know the finality, so the final head of accounts is not known. Therefore, it has to be kept somewhere till the nature of the transaction, the finality of the transaction, the correct allocation of the transaction is known. So for this purpose, we'll be using this suspense. So why it is required? Why it is required is because we do not know the nature of the transaction as a whole, as a completeness. Comprehensiveness of that transaction is not known. There are many examples. One example which I can clearly tell you is about the deposit work. Now, many works are executed in the railways for the outsiders, for the outside parties on deposit accounts. That means we will take money from them, we will execute the job and then do the job and give it to them. If you know that there are certain transactions in deposit account where the state governments or the roads and buildings will give us money to carry out the work of ROB, RUB. Sometimes some locos which are owned by private companies or rides, they will give that loco or wagons for maintenance in our loco sheds or workshops. For that, what we do, we take the money first and we have not incurred expenditure. So what we will do is we keep the money in a deposit. That means till the actual execution of the job is over, we do not know what is to be done with that amount. So as the expenditure or the work progresses, the expenditure will be booked against that depositor. Okay. In the same way, there are many inventory transactions. Inventory transactions would mean that it is related to stores accounts. So inventory is stores accounts. Then why there is a suspense in stores accounts? Because purchasing of stores is one activity, end user utilizing that stores is another activity. So till the time the end user really takes over that custody of the stores to utilize on his requirements, that accounts will be called inventory accounts under suspense. Okay, so on the earning side also we have suspense. On the earning side, why it is required? You can think that, you know, in traffic accounts, certain transactions we will undertake, but the money is not forthcoming. From, see, some parties are due to pay to us, some cash has not been received, although the cash was paid up to the railways. So all these transactions, some bills were raised from the military department, but they have not yet paid to us. All these transactions would be kept under the suspense accounts to watch their proper account. So this is the real purpose of suspense account. So we have to keep on watching what is due to us. We have to collect. So we have to bring it into account. So once we collect, then we will book it to the final. Similarly, what we have to pay to the others. Okay. So what we have to pay to the others, we have to keep a watch on that. Suddenly tomorrow we should not have a case where we are due so much to some other parties. So this is our liabilities as well as our receipts. Both sides we have to keep a watch. So till the finality of the transactions, allocations are not known, we will keep monitoring the progress of these transactions through the suspense accounts. Unless we have a suspense account, the transactions will be lost. So it is necessary we should have a proper accounting system. So generally these are the types of transactions we are having. Inventory, I told you, it is a stores transactions. Generally in stores transactions, the stores department will make a lot of procurements for the stores. It is called stores suspense. Then it is kept in a depot. Once we receive the stores and payments are made to the suppliers, we keep those stores in depots. So depot is only a stocking item. It is not utilized. So till the utilization takes place, the stores depot is responsible for accounting that stores and then keeping it under stores suspense. So this is a gap between the purchase and the utilization. So till that time it is kept in stores suspense. Then we are making some cash advances to certain agencies. Okay, why it is required? Why we should make anybody any cash advances? It is necessary in our day-to-day transactions. Why it is necessary? Now some stores we are procuring through pro forma invoice, it is called. Okay, now there are certain transactions which require advance payments. Now certain grease, oil or steel items, they have been approved for purchasing through pro forma invoice. That means we have to make advance payment. Then on receipt of that money only, he will supply the goods to us. So there is a gap between this payment made and receipt of material under its account. So that gap, we have to keep cash advances. Sometimes even in open line or some other units or production units, we will give some advances to our own officers to carry out certain transactions through cash advances. Like a spot purchase committee may be there, they want to buy certain items as approved by the spot purchasing authorities. They will go and make purchases, and then whatever bills are there, it will get paid up. But the money drawn for spot purchase will become advance till the bills are received and accounted for properly. So this is one way. Then accrued earnings are there. What is accrued earnings? Means accrued earnings means earnings which have already materialized, but we have not received the cash. So cash is shortfall. short dash has not come within the same time, so it will form suspense patterns. Similarly, allocations are not known. That means the finality of the transaction is not known, or sometimes one agency is purchasing, another agency is utilizing. So between two units, two departments, or two different heads of accountal, we have to transfer the transactions. That means we have to raise a debit or receive a credit. For that, some time is required. So that is also kept in suspense accounts. So we also have this RBI transactions when we do transactions with the other government agencies. Then generally we have classified these four general types of suspense head. One is a general suspense, where in any division or in any accounting unit there will be a general suspense. Then this traffic suspense is very specific to earning side, the traffic receipts. There it will be accounted in the FNCO traffic accounts, but part of it will also be contributed by the open line earning sections. Okay, so open line divisions may contribute some value to this traffic suspense through bills receivable. Then there's a stores is a big subject where a lot of procurement really happens. So many types of store suspense, we again further classified store suspense also. Then we all know there are many manufacturing units with us where we do a lot of manufacturing. So workshops are there, not only workshop manufacturing but also workshop for maintenance is there. So these maintenance and manufacturing units also have a suspense balance. So let us try to see one by one what are all these items. If anybody is having any doubt, you can please ask. As we progress, I'll keep on going, but if anybody is having any issue, you can please tell. So there is a revenue receipt as well as expenditure. So revenue receipt will become like this. What is revenue? Revenue means what is our day-to-day transactions. Okay, day-to-day receipts and day-to-day expenditure is revenue. So there's a traffic account, what we just now I told you. Traffic account is what are our traffic earnings from the stations. Okay, then there's demands recoverable. What is demands recoverable? That means we have to recover some money from the other agencies. So that is demands recoverable. What type of transaction can this be? Demands recoverable. Demands recoverable be can somebody who has to pay us some rent or land lease, or some government agency has to pay some license fees, bail in charges, are some LC gates are being operated at the cost of state governments, so they have to give us some maintenance charges. All these are demands recoverable. Then we also have under revenue demands payable. So demands payable is actually our we have to pay to the parties for whom who have done service to us. So demands payable is we have incurred some liability but it is undischarged. So this is undischarged liabilities will be accounted under demands payable. What type of undischarged liabilities we can have? Very clearly we can say we are giving salaries to everybody. So that is a liability for us. After working for 1 month, we have to pay salaries to all our employees. But if you don't discharge certain liabilities because it is not getting paid in somebody's account and all that, that will become undischarged liability. So unpaid wages can be one. Then some contractors' amounts because of some shortfall in documentation or shortfall in some information or some tax issues. Sometimes we'll be able to withhold his money. So that will also be undischarged. And then once the full details are known, we'll be able to release that amount to the contractors or suppliers or whatever it is. So in this way, demands payable will come under revenue receipts. So this is one suspense. Revenue expenditure. Okay, revenue expenditure. Then there is a MAR. MAR is an advance. Advance which we have paid to somebody. Now, what type of advance we have paid to somebody? I told you pro forma invoice is there. Some departmental officers, we are paying some money. Then we are also paying advances to some contractors called mobilization advance. So many types of advances will be there. But everything what we have to do is ensure that these are all current. Then under capital, we have a purchase suspense. Purchase suspense is the suspense which is maintained for accounting all the purchases. Okay, so as soon as the payment is made, it becomes a purchase suspense. Or once the receipt note is issued, it will match with that purchase suspense. Then it will get paid. So stores is there, stores in stock is there. So this is what is kept in the depot till the final utilization of the material at the end users. Then there's a workshop manufacture suspense is there. This will account this under capital. We are having demand number 16 is there. So the store suspense will come under planet 71. Workshop manufacturing suspense will come under 72. And this MAC will come under 70. So for capital expenditure, these are 71, 72, 73 are the three planets which are operated to take into account all the suspense balances. MAC would be required to, miscellaneous advance capital would be required to take into account all the material or stores which are given to outsiders for the purpose of further manufacturing or fabrication. Earlier, we used to have in workshops, we used to manufacture stores parts in workshops, earlier times. Now we are buying all the stores through market. But earlier we used to have all the stores manufactured in-house, in the workshops and manufacturing units. So in its process of manufacturing the item in a complete manner, certain stages will be required to be done through outside agencies. So they will take into account what value of the stores is issued to the contractor to execute his part of the job. So that will be accounted under MAC. Okay. Now, recently we are also accounting MAC for GST purposes. So, but this is quite different from the earlier times. Then on debt side, we have this loans and advances. These are all for the employees, computer, festival advance, some cycle advance, fan advance. Then this there's a deposit miscellaneous. So all the miscellaneous deposits which are accounted, these unpaid wages is there. Then so many miscellaneous deposits like contractors' money, these things are there. So we also have these EMDs are there, earnest money deposits. Then the security deposits are there. Then the performance guarantee deposits are there. Like that, so many deposits are there. Some electrical supply connections are there, which we are giving to outsiders, contractors. Some people are taking other facilities usage is there. So all these people will deposit some money with the rail. So once the transaction is complete, that deposit also has to be taken care of. So there are some remittance transactions. That means this is purely a matter of transactions with the banks. Okay, either we issue a check or we remit money to the bank, and we also do some transaction with some other departments or government department which is not a ministry. So like that, there's a Reserve Bank suspense. There is a remittance into bank. Now all the transactions which ultimately result in earnings have to be remitted. It can be in a division, in a headquarter, in a cash office, wherever. They will remit the money into the bank. So that is a deposit account. And what expenditure is incurred, that we will have to issue some checks for that, some transactions. So which will result in outflow of the money. That is a checks and bills account. So these transactions to ultimately take materialization will take some time. So till that time, till the bank actually gives us credit for remittance, or till the bank gives us the debit for checks and bills, that till that time, these amounts are kept in suspense. So There is also a PO suspense for intergovernmental transactions. Then under general suspense, see, I have just made out lot of matter is also in these slides, but you need not read everything, but if you want to have a further reference on this, you can just read through some like bullets. I have made out some points on this, but we'll just go through this one by one. So here this is miscellaneous advances. Okay, there's a local purchase is there, or how this account is actually transacted, it will be debited. So all advances will become debit. So ultimately, if you have a debit balance, that means you have given somebody some advance. So debit balance will indicate amount yet to be remitted or recovered. So this is the miscellaneous advance. So it can be due to purchases made, it can be due to some spot purchase committee, what I was telling you earlier. Recently, we have given in our division some spot purchase for furniture, for some, I think RPF is also taking some spot purchase for some dog pups they are buying and then training it up. Then generally when officers go on inspection and all that, they will hire a car and then pay some advances to the car. So later on the receipts will be accounted. So there is how this. So we require some documentary proof so that this can be adjusted. So this is a operation of, then there is a demands payable. So payable means railway has to pay. So this is towards the liquidation of undischarged liabilities. So it is a liability for us, but it was not discharged at the proper time. So it can be due to whatever salaries we are not able to pay to certain accounts due to whatever is the reason. Bank problem, our software problem, whatever. So so here it will become credit. So if there is some credit balance, it means we are having some undischarged liabilities. So what will happen if you are having a debit balance? It means if you are having a debit balance here, it means the account is not proper. Always demands payable should show a credit balance. Only then it will become our liability to discharge. But if the wrong account or wrong transactions take place, then it will be showing credit balance. It may not pertain to this. Okay, so it exists items for only undischarged liability. You can see here very clear. Okay, there should be no debit items. Deposit miscellaneous to watch discharge of due fulfillment, whatever. Shortfall I told is on documentation of bills passing for the contractors or suppliers. So all these things we have to fulfillment once it happens regarding the documentation or the information to be furnished by the agencies, then we will be able to discharge our liabilities. Okay. Amounts will be credited first because it's a deposit. We'll be having some money with us. Once the information or the transaction is fulfilled, then it will be adjusted against the final. Debited with subsequent payments made to credit by credit to checks and bills. Okay, so this is how it will be clear. So this will show always a credit balance. There should be no debit items. Then the other head which we were speaking of is the traffic suspense. Traffic earnings is the main source of earnings for the railways. So here our aim should be to ensure that the full earnings, what we are accounting, should be realized within the same accounting period. So however, certain items will be unrealized, not clear when it will going to come. So those transactions are accrued earnings, so it will be showing as unrealized earnings. So they are classified against in coaching and goods. And there is one more head called accounts office outstanding. Then there is a cash in transit and demands recovered. So coaching transactions are separately accounted. You all know traffic accounts. there are three X, Y, and Z are the main classification heads of coaching, goods, and sundry. So, coaching transactions are accounted separately. So, all earnings which are accrued but not realized under coaching will come there. And then, similarly, for goods and generally, sundry will not happen. Sundry is only an earnings. Okay. Then, in accounts office, what will happen? In accounts office, all the vouchers which are generated at the station regarding the billing on other departments, like maybe it's a military account or it's a postal department account or some other account, where we have to, we would have taken some instead of cash, we would have taken a voucher or a bill or a credit voucher. So that voucher has to be billed against that department to realize our earnings. So instead of cash, we would have taken some other document. So take into account that document, we are having this accounts office outstanding. Then cash in transit is one thing which we can very seriously monitor in the month of March especially, because we want to bring into account the cash of March within the March accounts so that it becomes accountable in the same year of transaction. Okay. So, this cash in transit, why it actually arises? Earlier, you all know that cash we used to send through trains in safe. Okay, the safe used to go to that cash office, traffic cash office. There it used to get opened and then accounted. And then it used to go and get remitted in the bank. But I think nowadays we are having so many banks coming forward to take into our earnings. And then they are doing some door-to-door service also. They are collecting the cash and giving the receipts immediately. So, now this safe movement has reduced considerably. And importance to that safe movement has also reduced. Especially all the big stations or all the major collection points, we are having banking facilities. So, we are directly remitting all the money into the banks directly. So the movement, physical movement as such is controlled now. So cash in transit is also, importance has been reduced now. But however, there are so many stations where some facilities would not be available. Remote locations are there. So there we have to ensure that definitely that cash also is accounted within the same year. However, certain issues may arise towards the end of March where, you know, it will not be possible to account. So, some balance amount of March will be accounted in the month of April in the following year. So, that will form what is called cash in transit. So, then there is a demands recoverable. Demands recoverable is also accounted in traffic because it's an earnings. So, what we have to recover from some sidings, from some private agencies, due to the services which we are offering, some land, some LC gate, state government is utilizing and we are providing manpower. So, all these things will become demands recovery. Okay. So, it may be participated by the divisions in open line, but the realization and then it will be transferred to the traffic accounts to keep it under demands recovery. So, this is what the station outstandings comprises of. It is a freight. Why freight is outstanding? Freight will be outstanding. Like you know, freight booking is both on paid and to pay. Nowadays, to pay is not much, but everything is paid up. So, this freight outstanding will not be much. Now, this is all classification of the earlier times also. But still that freight is outstanding due to the party has not come and taken delivery of that material. So, it is a freight outstanding. Okay. So, then this demurrage awaiting realization is one thing. Many parties don't pay up demurrage on the spot and then they wait for some transactions to happen and they want some waivers of demurrage. So, it will be outstandings in the months of the transaction, and then subsequently, when either they pay up or they are getting credit for that from major parties, then they will be clearing that. So we are having some big parties, like, you know, powerhouses is there, electricity boards are there, and some cement sidings are there, big parties, FCI is there. So these people to have, we also maintain some good relations, we'll try to give some waiver of some percentages. So that is how it is. This is what happens in accounts of his balance sheet, what we were discussing earlier. So realization from the firms or departments concerned, whatever we wanted to charge them for the carriage bills. That means we have taken some bill from them at the time of the point of transaction. That means some military passenger, some military goods we have taken and carried, but they have not paid cash, but they have paid bills, which has to be billed against the department concerned. So that to take it into account, this we are taking this from the accounts office balance sheet is the proper form of maintenance of that account. So it will come through station balance sheet as a voucher, and then it will get billed in the accounts office. So that is how this actually happens. So this is what I was telling you, cash in transit, cash realized by the stations in the month, irrespective of whether it is remitted and acknowledged by the cashier in that month or in the subsequent month. Such station cash for which credit has been allowed, but which has been received in the cash office on the third and following month, consequently included in the general cash, general books in the following month, is called cash. So transaction actually realized in 1 month, but it is accounted in the general cash book of the railways in the following month. So this is how this cash is forming cash in transit. Then demands recoverable is there. What I was telling you, land rent, engineering department, commercial department. So engineering department gives so much land for outsiders on lease charges, like it's called a land license fees, rental charges. Then the commercial department also has commercial plots at many stations, which are given to some big parties for necessary for their operations of loading and unloading. So there is also, when we are having sidings, we are having charges called interest and maintenance charges on sidings. Many buildings are on rent for other departments, and you know, like police department or CRPF or PNT department, postal is there. Then this level crossing also we are maintaining for the state governments at their request. So these are all demands recoverable. So before I tell about demands, go to another topic, demands recoverable. I want to also tell you about bills recoverable. There is a related topic called bills recoverable. What is bills recoverable? Bills recoverable are all the bills raised on certain parties for which we have done some service. Now, for example, in the division, we would have provided some staff to a siding authority for taking out their commercial transactions. But for providing staff, we will charge them that money also. Whatever we paid to the staff, that much money we will charge. Okay, staff cost we call. So we would have, some siding would have also had some repair or some derailment or something. So that also, so that value also we want to recover from them. Okay, so whenever the executive raises these bills, so accounts department will bring all these bills into account and raise against the concerned parties. So these are all bills recoverable. But certain bills recoverable will be contributing to traffic earnings. Those will become bills, those will become demands recoverable. and certain bills which we realize will contribute to reduction in our expenditure. That we will account in the division itself or the open line itself and then reduce our expenditure, and that will be part of the bills recovery. So all bills need not be reduction in expenditure. Certain bills which we raise can contribute to traffic earnings. Certain bills which we raise can contribute to reduction in expenditure. So what we contribute to traffic earnings will be accounted separately in advance as a suspense balance. But what we raise bills and account as a reduction in expenditure, we will do it within the accounting year in the division itself, for which there will be no suspense balance. So this one clear understanding we should have about how bills recoverable and demands recoverable will be taken into account. So both are recoverable, bills are recoverable as well as demands are recoverable. But demands recoverable will be contributing to the earnings in traffic. So that is also part of bills recoverable. And what bills recoverable we undertake for reduction in expenditure will not form part of the traffic suspense. Now, what is that which will contribute to traffic suspense? Like I told you, here they are interest maintenance charges, inspection charges, rent on buildings, ROB, FOBs. These will contribute to, we will raise bills on these and then we will contribute to that to the traffic suspense. And then clear those accounts. But if you provide service of manpower to a siding, railway employees, then we will realize that through bills on the sidings, and then we'll reduce our expenditure. So that will become bills recoverable for the divisions. So this is one clear definition we should have in our mind. Everything will not be traffic suspense demands recovery. Then on the store side, we are having different types of accountants. There is a stores imported, indigenous, fuel, sale other than fuel, sale of fuel, stores in stock. There are many accounts, separate, you know, subsidiary store suspenses. These are all main store suspenses kept in so many different forms to have a proper account and all that. Then there's also a stock adjustment account is there. And then what I was telling you, MSC is there. MSC is also that transaction which I told you, some material will be issued to outsiders. So these are the different ones. So one by one, let us have a quick view on these items. So, you know, imported stores we used to buy earlier. Now, I think not much imported stores, except some places. But indigenous, many stores we are buying through stores department. Then fuel we are purchasing. Fuel is this HSG oil we are purchasing. And then biofuel also we are purchasing. We are also selling. Selling will be accounted in sales. What is that we are selling? We are selling scrap. We are also selling some stores. So whatever we are selling will account in sales. This is other than fuel and this is fuel. And what we are having stores in the stock, that means all the stores depots are there. Now there is a wonderful mechanism available for accountal of all the stores through that system of IMMS. That's a good stores program is running. And it is you know, online system, and everything, all transactions are available online. So the users are able to properly account all the stores and also have a clear view across the railways. What are the various stores in the stock? Okay. So that is all stock material will be kept in stores in stock suspense till it is issued to the end user. End user can be mechanical department, S&T department, engineering department, any other department. So till it is issued, it is kept in stores. So once it is issued, only the finality will come to know. So at that point of time, the stores in stock is released and then the debit is raised against that department. Then there is all these are capital suspense. I have to keep on telling you, there are some capital suspense, there are some revenue suspenses. So stores itself, I told you, it is Planet 71. So this is Planet 71 store suspense. So everything is capital. Then there is a stores in transit. Stores in transit would mean stores which is transferred from one place to another place, but the accounting period will change before it is accounted at the end. So it was issued in 1 month but accounted another month. So the transit is taking place. So to have a adjustment in that, we'll keep it in the suspense balance for the time. That means stores in stock will be released. It will get accounted in stores in transit, and then once it reaches the other end of the depot, then again from stores in transit it will be released and then taken into stores in stock. So this is the transaction. Between stores in stock and stores in transit, there will be not much difference, except it is not available in stock. It is in the movement. So therefore it is called stores in transit. Okay, so then stock adjustment is also there. What is the stock adjustment? Sometimes the stock value or stores in stock has to be adjusted because of the numbers or because of the value. Sometimes some stock is destroyed, sometimes there is a like fuel, sometimes you know calibration problems are there, there is a wastage is there, there is a you know fire destroying is there, sometimes the stock is lost, sometimes something happens. So all these things have to be accounted. Sometimes some stock is found, sometimes some stock is lost. So all these adjustments are happening. Sometimes these ASVs and IACs also do some inspection and arrive at some differences in the book and the physical balances. So that is also adjusted through the stock adjustment. Then what I told you earlier, MAC is there, miscellaneous advance under capital, planned 73 is there. So here we account for the material which we are giving to outsiders. But it will be coming back, then we will be able to take it from. So how this purchase account is operated? Purchase is the first action in the stores. We will issue the purchase order. The material will be received in the stores depot. Then this purchase action happens. So that is what the purchase account all means. So before the material which is received was paid up, there is some gap. So, you know, received and payment, there is a gap. So here this purchase account will be operated in that gap. Okay. When the receipt note is received by debit to stores in stock. Okay. So once the material is received, it will be debited to stores in stock. That will be credit of purchase account and debit to stores in stock. So how it is released? Bill is passed. So when the bill is passed, this purchase account will be released. So when the material is received in the stores depot, the account will start in the purchase account by credit, and when the bill is passed for payment against that receipt of stores, then the matter is nullified. That is debited. So this is how this is. This is the order in which it should happen. That means first we should have a credit. First we should not have a debit. As a meaning. Okay, first we should receive the material and then only we should make payment. If you make payment first and then receive the material, it will not be correct transaction. So it also means this purchase account, we should always have a credit balance. That means payment is due to the parties. Then we have a sale. Like I told you, we are selling through auction sale. So here there are two types of transactions in sales. One is we will do auction sales, we will get the money, then we will deliver the material. In another transaction, what will happen? We will deliver the material, then we will get the monetary value. So these are two different types. Okay. So credit will appear earlier than the debit when we get the cash first, and then we will deliver later on the material which we have sold. Like, you know, there are some track renewal works which happen in the open line. Lot of scrap material is released. This old rails will be old rails fittings. Okay, all these things will be put to scrap. Then line lots are created and sale will take place through auction sales online. So the stores department will do these auction sales. then the bidders will pay the money, and then later on only when they paid the full value of that sale, only then the material will be delivered to the agency who has taken the material. Now railway will sell first, take the money, then the material will be delivered. So that is the first type of transaction. So credit will come first, and once the material was delivered, then the debit will come. It will nullify the earlier. Okay, so this is what happens. But the other transaction is can.
Beta, no, this is sorry, Gavatla.
Hello. Okay. The other transaction is the debit will appear first, where we deliver the material first. Now, for example, I can tell you. Lot of wheel axles and wheel sets are given to rail wheel plant at Bangalore, Yelahanka is there. So all the such scrapped rail wheel sets, like axles and wheels, are transferred to this rail wheel factory. So we are giving the material first to them. Sometimes we also give material to certain agencies who will buy the stores from us. Okay, some other government department may be there, some other railway may be there, some other. So what we are doing is we are transferring the material first, and then we are making some adjustment with them at a later date. So here the debit will appear first, and the credit will come later on, only when we will have clearance of that transfer. So transfer certificates will come. Sports is strong. This is the biggest head in
department.
Okay, some disturbance is there. I request all to mute your mics so that people can listen to it clearly. Okay. Now, stores in stock represents all the stores depots where stores is available in their custody. So, this is stores in stock. So, how the stores really comes to their stock? We have done one purchase activity earlier, so that we have released the purchase and then it has now come into the stores in stock. So SIS is there, stores in stock. So debit when the stores is received. That means as soon as the stores is received from the supplier, debit will come. And this debit will be nullified once the user department takes the custody of the stores, or it is a requesting issue and we are issuing the stores from the debit. Now, who are the end users of this? Generally, you will find that all local sheds, all big units like workshops and manufacturing units like production houses will have a associated stores depot also. So, these stores depots will cater requirements of those units like local shed or workshop or manufacturing. So they will keep all the stores required for these workshops or depots, workshops or local sheds readily with them. And as and when these stores are required, they'll keep on delivering to the end user. End user is a workshop or a manufacturing unit or a local shed. So all these. The period between the stores received and the period between the stores received and issue will be the debit balance in the suspended of stores. Okay. So, this is how it is operated. You can just have a read on this. So, they will be issuing imported stores or indigenous stores when it is received. They will have debit is the receipt in the depot. Credit is the issue. Okay. So you can see the earlier slide. What we have written here? Debit is the stores received. Credit is the stores issued. So here you can see how it is operated. When we receive stores, either indigenous or imported from the suppliers, we will also receive some stores from manufacturing units like workshops and production house, production units. So that time also the stores will be received and accounted in the stores depot. So from WMS also it will come. Then works for stores returned, sometimes some excess goods is returned and it is accounted in the depot itself. So that is also returned stores it is called. Sometimes one depot to another depot transfers is called, that is stores in transit depot transfers. Okay. Then on account of MAC, we may be issuing for fabrication to some other agency or some other unit. So at that point of time also, when they are received back, that is received, when they are received back, then we again debit will come to the stores. Similarly, credit will come when we are issuing to for the sale purpose, when we are issuing to the workshop for the end user, when we are issuing to the revenue or works matters. Revenue is a division for maintenance of locos and carriages and wagon or track maintenance. Some stores are required. When we are issuing to another depot, we are releasing these stores. And we are also issuing to fabrication, that is issue. That time we will reduce our stores in stock. So this is credit and that is, okay. So that is about stores in stock operations. Then stores in transit, I told you earlier, stores in transit is regarding the transfer of stores from one unit to another unit. Depot transfer it is called. So for the time it is issued and for the time it is received by another depot, this period will be accounted in stores in transit. The value of that stores will be accounted in stores in transit. So this life should be very less. It should not exceed more than 2 or 3 months at the most, that is. But it should be accounted in the same month as far as possible. Okay, so this is about this one. Then there is a stock in stock adjustment account is also there. Why there is a difference in stock and why there is a difference in value. So these are the two parts, one and two. So there is a ledger balance and the physical balance. That difference is there. Due to stock verification also, sometimes we become aware that some excess or shortage will be there. Sometimes we will be able to revalue the stores also. So when you do revaluation also, and sometimes one depot rate and another depot rate will be differing based on their bar it is called, book average rates. Book average rate may differ from one place to another place. That time also valuation differences. Okay. Sometimes there's a loss. There are other adjustments. Past three is miscellaneous. There may be breakage, leakage. Okay. So all these are miscellaneous items. For stock adjustment, that means value of the stock is adjusted through stock sheets. Then this lot of English I have made out here, but this is called workshop manufacturing suspense. Okay, so I'll just give a brief on this workshop manufacturing suspense. In a workshop, what happens is lot of servicing takes place. Like we take our vehicle for servicing, either in a car or two wheeler. Or any other mixie or grinder or fridge or something, we take for a servicing. So then what happens, that fellow will keep servicing for us and then he'll charge some money to us, we pay him and then come. In the same way, these workshops, what they will do is, they will do servicing to the railway assets. What are the assets which we are having? It can be a loco, it can be a coach, it can be a wagon, it can be other assets. Okay, so now suppose we are having one workshop which is doing servicing to carriages. So it's a carriage workshop. Similarly, we have a wagon workshop. Similarly, we have a workshop for track machines. There are so many track machines available with us on the Indian Railways. So the track machines also require regular service. So all these things will be done in a unit called workshop. Similarly, there is a manufacturing unit. You know, we are having manufacturing of locos, that we are having manufacturing of wagons and other rolling stock also. So all these units will maintain one account called workshop manufacturing suspense. What is the role of this workshop manufacturing suspense? Initially, to do servicing, some expenditure is incurred. What type of expenditure is incurred? Now, for example, we'll take the example of a carriage repair shop. So their main duty is to repair carriages, do POH activity, do some servicing, do some 18 months servicing or periodical overhauling. IOH and POH are activities are there regularly. So these transactions they will undertake in their workshop. So to know what is the work they are having, they'll prepare a budget in which they will sell. These are the assets due for POH activity for the year. So based on that budget, they will divide the budget into all the necessary elements of the requirements. One is the labor, one is the stores, and one is the other issues. Okay, so basically we require men and material for doing POH. So labor and stores make a big contribution in workshop manufacturing assessments. So the labor is available with them only, all their manpower, salaries and everything is a investment on the servicing of the asset. Similarly, they draw so much stores for renewing the parts or repairing the parts or removing the old parts and replacing with the new parts. They require so much stores. So all that will be mitigated. So first, their expenditure starts by putting the labor on work and drawing the material. So this activity of incurring expenditure will be first booked in the same month in the WMS account. Okay, whenever we are paying salary, we'll book it to WMS. And whenever we are drawing stores, we'll book it to WMS. So this is how the transaction starts in the WMS. Now what will happen? The work will be over maybe within 15 days, 20 days. Then the asset will be released to the stockholder. Whoever is the depot in charge of that carriage, the depot will go, the carriage will go to him. Then he'll start running his train. Now, what workshop has to do is, for whatever expenditure it has incurred on the servicing part, that much expenditure it has to debit to the depot or the unit where this asset was owned by. The asset is owned by a division, then the debit will go to a division. If the asset is owned by another railway, the debit will go to the other railway. So once the debit is going there, the unit which has received the service and the debit is also received by them, it has to afford credit to the workshop. So once the credit comes there, then this earlier debit will be, we can say liquidated, and then the balance will become less. So to do transactions, you book all the expenditure to WMS, then wherever you have done transactions and then release the assets after servicing, you have to recover the amount from those owners or those asset owners where you have done the servicing. And once the money comes from them, either to transfer or whatever, then your assets will, your WMS balances will become liquidated. So what is the balance representing now? All the balances which represent under WMS will be the transactions for which you have done expenditure, incurred expenditure you can say, but you have not realized. So one part is incurring expenditure, another part, if you put a ledger account for WMS, one is incurring expenditure on the left side, another side is realization. So our incurring expenditure and realization should be matching. But we may incur more expenditure but realize it at a later date. So naturally what will happen is the incurring expenditure side, that's the debit side, will be slightly higher than the realization part. So that will only form the closing balance. So this closing balance will be due to mainly unrealized credits or works in progress. That means you are still working on some asset to do servicing. POH is taking some time, or it is in the end of the accounting period, so it will run into the next year also. So that type of action will be there in the workshop. And this manufacturing suspense, there are some guidelines also. How much balance you can keep in a manufacturing suspense. You cannot keep all the balances just like that. So normally a board will tell that you have to keep only 3% of your gross credits. So there's a limitation. That means you have to quickly realize credits also from the agencies or the units for whom you have done service.
सॉरी सर, ये सस्पेंस से हेड का काफी बजट बनाया याद आता है क्या? क्योंकि ऑल जब सारे का फाइनल इन पे जब जांच किया जाता है तो सर तो बनना चाहिए कि नहीं बनना चाहिए?
हेलो
वेदर सर, whether budget of suspense is prepared or not. Whether budget is prepared or not, sir?
Prepared or not, sir? Hello?
Sir?
Hello, who is talking? हेलो, कौन बात कर रहे हैं?
अनिल बोल रहा हूँ सर.
ओके, एक मिनट, मैं अभी ना एक काम करता हूँ, मेरा प्रेजेंटेशन ऑलमोस्ट आ गया है. आज ना हम लोग डिस्कशन करेंगे इसके बारे में. आपका कोई डाउट रहा, कोई विचार रहा सर, एंड इफ एनी क्लैरिटी इज रिक्वायर्ड आल्सो क्लैरिफाई ऑल द इश्यूज.
ओके,
ठीक है. जस्ट आई एम कमिंग टुवर्ड्स द एंड. जस्ट
ओके,
ये WMS हो गया अभी. हाउ इट इज ऑपरेटेड, इट इज डेबिटेड विथ ऑल द एक्सपेंडिचर. ओके, मटेरियल रहा, वेजेस रहा, सैलरीज रहा, परचेसेस रहा. परचेस यू नो, डायरेक्ट परचेस इज वन आइटम. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ डायरेक्ट परचेस? दैट मींस इट इज नॉट परचेस थ्रू द.
अरे बाप रे बाप, मेरे को तो छिलने के लिए कैसे आ गया था. बता बता बता.
So direct purchase is the purchase order issued, but the depot is not active in that transaction. It will come direct to the end user. That's a direct purchase. Okay. So ये पूरा expenditure रहा, फिर then ये credit कैसा होगा? जो जो काम हम लोगों ने realize कर लिया है, जिसका काम हम कर चुके थे, whatever we have realized, that is you know what credits we got. By debit to works, okay, by debit to capital suspense and debit to revenue, like we are doing some POH and you know CR and SR. So this is how we realize all the WMS credits. So closing balance will represent only unrealized credits or works in work orders which are in progress. Completed ones which are credit is awaited. Debits हम लोगों ने raise किया है which is not accepted. अभी accept करने में उनके पास budget का problem रहा, जो कुछ भी problem रहा, we are have to keep it in WMS balance. ठीक है? So these are all the items which will form balance in WMS. So we are having some reserve bank suspense also. So non railway government departments जो transactions होगा उसको हम लोग ये थोड़ा इंग्लिश जा रहा है इसके अंदर, बाद में आप कैन रीड स्लोली. सो चेक्स एंड बिल्स इन द स्टार्टिंग आई टोल्ड यू व्हाट ऑल वी डू. इशू रिलीज पेमेंट्स विल फर्स्ट हैव चेक्स एंड बिल्स इन ऑपरेशन. ओके, सो विल क्रेडिट चेक्स एंड बिल्स फर्स्ट. देन व्हेन द बैंक विल क्लियर आवर ट्रांजैक्शंस विल गेट द debit also. So we have to keep on having a reconciliation of the checks and bills. Very very important at places. Okay. So we would have issued some check, but it was not encashed. We would have issued some payment, but it was not materialized as payment to some account holder. So that we have to get it back from the bank and keep it with our checks and bills. Okay. So sometimes it happens that these transactions will never materialize. So old items we have to transfer to sundry items. Then we are remitting into the bank. Our daily earnings, we are there. Some EMD people are coming and paying. Some service charges people are coming and paying. Whatever they are paying into the railway accounts, they are giving us checks or DDs. So that we are remitting into the bank. So once you remit into the bank, this will become transaction in operation. It will become debit. And then once the bank clears those transactions, that means you give credit to us. Okay? So till that time, you have to come in. So what all we send to the bank for remittance, you have to ensure that the railway got the money, the treasury got the money. So for that monitoring only this remittance into bank. So there's a pure suspense. Payments to be made on behalf of accounts officers are yet to be recovered. Outstanding credit balance under the suspense would mean that payments have to be received by PO on behalf of Tripura Pay and accounts guy. Okay. So remittance transactions is one more transaction between Ministry of Railways and other ministries. There's a new transaction. Now, how it is to be? Now we are discussing so many transactions. How it is classified? Why it is there? How it is there? Everything is there. Now, how to clear it? Like I told you earlier, suspense itself means a very short time duration. So, if you keep it for long duration, the purpose is defeated. That means we are not doing our work properly. So it has to be held temporarily only. So either we have to pay up or we have to realize recovery ya payment karna hai. So then only it will become clearance. So what are the reasons for the growth? Why it is keep on increasing? Okay. Because of these reasons. We have to realize the importance. Now, the more suspense balance increases, that means the more inefficiency is there in the accounting system and the transaction happening. The more the transactions are efficient and current, that much system is working in a proper way. So, we have to realize that full potential. Potential of the executive as well as the accounts. Both are responsible for this. Okay. Indiscriminate booking to suspense head has to be avoided. Okay. Every transaction has to be booked to the final head to take it to the finality. But we should try to avoid the suspense head route whenever we think that, okay, for the time being, we can keep it in suspense head. Okay. So that we have to avoid. So as early as possible, will either debit to the relevant head or transfer to other accounting we have to undertake. So these are the ways of, these are the reasons for growth. Then what is that suspense clearance we can do? Both executive and accounts are responsible for clearance of suspense matters. So, but basically accountant is the accounts office. So, accounts office has to take a lot of lead in clearance of suspense balance by having regular interaction with our executive side. Branch officers meeting raha, headquarters mein meeting raha. So, we have to keep on projecting these items. So, we should have a proper accountant also. Correct posting is required, balancing is required. Okay. So, this is how we have to take clearances. If you don't clear, what will happen? So the operating ratio will be faulty. Okay, we would have incurred expenditure a lot, but we are not booked into the final head. But so the earnings will not be truly reflected. Expenditure will not be truly reflected. So it will affect the operating ratio. Budgeting process, it will defeat what we are doing budgeting for. It will defeat, it will vitiate the budgeting process. Okay, moreover, if you allow the suspense to remain for a long time, a flex of time, okay, you will not be able to recover. These will become hardcore items. Sometimes some frauds can happen because it is lying in suspense for years together. You do not know what is the rate, what is the transaction all about. Okay, as the transaction become older and older, lesser information, lesser records are available to regularize that transaction. These are the effects. So generally suspense also links up the capital and revenue accounts. Like stores is a capital suspense. When the material is issued to the departments, it becomes a revenue transaction. So if you keep it in capital and not book it to revenue, revenue is affected. So that way you have to transfer to the capital or revenue in a proper way. All this is actually done as a review by the railway board also. So what railway board does is does a half yearly review of suspense balances. So what all balances we have discussed now will become a review for the railway. Railway board takes it up as an item of review every March and every September ending. We draw the balances and give reasons why we are having these suspense balances. So we project it to the railway board also. Then we tell the railway board why. We will do analysis on that. What is the analysis we do? We either do a year-wise analysis or a cause-wise analysis and ensure that in year-wise we are not having older years. That means everything we have to bring it down to the current year. That is one analysis, and then also causes. Why we should keep something which is not required. So the cause is very, very important. Why we should book something to the suspense set. That cause is very, very important. So cause-wise and year-wise profiles are taken. So March and September, from the headquarters, it will go to the railway board, but all units will prepare their own. Railway board in that review will also communicate the adverse or whatever issues are noticed by them. So generally it happens like that. But what we give to railway board is once in 6 months only. But what we are required to do in the units is on a regular basis we have to take up. There should be no question of having to wait up to 30th September or 31st March. If you wait up to 31st March and 31st September, the action is already over. So before that only, you have to do some reviews. So this review is not for the board, actually it is for the units where these balances are made. So we are required to do a regular review. At least, see, once in a month, we can have a review of the suspense balances. Then only we can project a current and efficient suspense balance. Okay? So these are the reviews. This is my presentation. I hope all of you have understood. And then I would like to hear any comments from you.
Hello, sir.
Sir, namaste. Budget banaya jata hai ya nahi banaya jata hai? Sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Sir, namaste. Hello, sir.
If anybody wants to talk, you first tell who you are and what is your point of view. We can just.
Sir, namaste. LS Basav sir here.
Okay.
Sir, I want one clarification, sir. Sir, what are the concrete steps we are taking, sir, to keep traffic balance, traffic suspense at the minimum, sir?
Traffic suspense?
Yes, sir.
Traffic suspense, biggest balance is on account of coaching and goods. Hello?
Hello?
Traffic suspense, sir. Biggest contribution is made by unrealized earnings against coaching and goods. So, if you take control of the unrealized earnings, it means you have to contact, you have to keep, if you are working in traffic accounts, you have to keep regular contact with the big parties who are paying through credit notes and other transactions which is not cash related. That way, then this demurrage warfage is one other issue. Either you have to work out to give waiver or make collection of the demurrage and mortgage. So all this requires a lot of coordination actually. See, the
yes, sir.
Earnings will come, but But simply because we are having outstanding, they will not be able to do. But
Next.
Sir, hello. Namaste, sir. I am Padmini here. Sir, you were talking about the capital suspense at 7100 and under the planet 7100, 7200 and all.
Yeah.
In that context, you were referring to purchase suspense also. So it is also a capital suspense on, sir?
The 7100 includes all the stores suspense heads.
Okay,
whether
sir.
It is purchase or stores in stock or whatever it is. Stores in transit, stock adjustment account, they will all be contributing towards 7100 only. Their numbers allocation, if you see, it will start with 2071. 20 represents capital, and 71 represents the planet.
Okay, sir. And purchase suspense, sir?
Purchase is also part of self-stores only.
Achha, okay, sir. Thanks.
The other digits will only, the ending digits will only vary. See, starting digits, these four will be same.
Achha. Even for purchase suspense, it starts with 2071 only.
Correct.
Sir, yeah, pata hai sir ki purchase suspense. Hello.
Batao.
बोले सर अगर परचेज इन एडवांस का पेमेंट अगर करते हैं सर ऑन परफॉर्मा इनवॉइस या आरआर पर प्रूफ ऑफ आरआर पर तो उस टाइम तो परचेज सर्कल को डेबिट करके हम सेक्शन को क्लियर करते हैं तो उस टाइम तो डेबिट होता है सर वो
उसको पहले एडवांस में बुक करना पड़ेगा आपको उसमें परचेज सस्पेंस बाद में आएगा
अच्छा
पहले आपने पहले पैसा दे दिया है ना
हां अगर पहले पैसा देंगे सर प्रूफ ऑफ आरआर वगैरह पेमेंट करते हैं सर
एडवांस में बुक करना पड़ेगा पहले
वो परचेज सस्पेंस बुकिंग नहीं होगा सर
वो उसमें नहीं
नहीं होगा
इसमें क्या होगा पहले पैसा निकल जाएगा
हाँ
बाद में मटेरियल आएगा स्टोर्स इन स्टॉक होगा
हाँ
तो उसका जब आरओ आएगा वो एडवांस न्यूट्रलाइज होगा
अच्छा एडवांस से होगा
ये परचेज जो होगा वो सिंपली आफ्टर रिसीप्ट ऑफ मटेरियल जो हम लोग पेमेंट करते हैं
अच्छा सर
उसमें परचेज सस्पेंस
अरे और क्वेश्चन सर चेक्सन बिल्स बताया सर चेक्सन बिल सस्पेंस का सर तो चेक्सन बिल सस्पेंस का सर जो आइटम पड़ा रह जाएगा सर उसको अर्निंग में ट्रांसफर करते हैं या डिपॉजिट में डाल देंगे सर जो कंसर्न सेक्शन डिपॉजिट होगा जैसे डिपॉजिट पेंशन डिपॉजिट पीएफ डिपॉजिट एस्टैब्लिशमेंट क्योंकि तो पेमेंट
क्या होता है वेजेस वेजेस हम लोग क्या करेंगे अनपेड वेजेस में रखेंगे
हां
देखिए चेक्सन बिल्स हम लोगों ने सैलरी किसी का दिया है सैलरी दिया है बट उसका वहाँ पर बैंक अकाउंट क्रेडिट नहीं हुआ है बाद में हो नहीं पाया आफ्टर सिक्स मंथ्स एट मंथ्स व्हाटएवर इट इज अनपेड वेजेस है ना कॉन्ट्रैक्टर का मनी रहा सो क्लेम नहीं आया तो वो तो इंश्योरेंस डिपॉजिट में चले जाएगा
यस सर अरे चेक
वो चेक्स एंड बिल से हम लोग निकाल देंगे बीच में
और चेक्स एंड बिल क्लियर होगा तो सर डिपॉजिट में ही भेजेंगे आइदर डिपॉजिट अनपेड या डिपॉजिट में सेलेनियस इट डायरेक्टली नॉट गोइंग टू अर्निंग
उसको बाद में क्लियरेंस करने का जो जो डिपॉजिट अकाउंट रहेगा उसका जो रूल्स रहेगा जैसा सैलरी है तो हम लोग वो एसपीएफ में जोड़ देंगे
हां 3 साल के बाद चल जो होता है
हां तो या तो हम लोग इसमें जोड़ते हैं और जोड़ते
हैं हेलो सर
ओके सर थैंक यू
हेलो सर अभिनीत सर क्या सर बजट बनाया जाता है क्या मतलब हेलो जी सर क्या सर सस्पेंस का बजट बनाया
जाता है क्या सस्पेंस का भी बजट बनता है
जब फाइनल एंड में जब बुक करना तब तो उसमें बजट बनाया जाता है
हाँ उसमें भी बजट बनता है उसका भी हम लोग टारगेट्स मेंटेन करना चाहिए यू कैन नॉट बुक एवरीथिंग टू सस्पेंस
सस्पेंस को फाइनल एंड में बुक करते ही है तो वहां जब बजट का प्रोविजन कर दिए तो फिर सस्पेंस में करने की क्या जरूरत है सर
नहीं नहीं सस्पेंस का मतलब है ओनली सर्टेन ट्रांजैक्शंस यू कैन कीप इट इन द परव्यू ऑफ सस्पेंस एवरी ट्रांजैक्शन यू शुड नॉट पुट टू सस्पेंस फर्स्ट है ना तो व्हाट इज वेरी क्लियर यू कैन नॉट पुट इट टू सस्पेंस तो उसके लिए उसका भी एक बजट होगा। प्लैनेट 71 में वर्कशॉप मैन्युफैक्चरिंग का बजट होगा, 72 में वर्कशॉप होगा, 71 में स्टोर्स का बजट होगा सस्पेंस का, 73 में एमएससी का बजट होगा, उसी तरह एमएआर रेवेन्यू का होगा बजट। उसको कंट्रोल करने के लिए भी बेस्ड ऑन पास्ट ट्रेंड्स ओनली वी हैव टू कीप द बजट फॉर सस्पेंस आल्सो। Like I told you, railway board guidelines है, WMS का कितना रहना चाहिए? करीब 3%।
Yes.
तो उसका बजट 3% ही रहेगा।
सर, डिमांड रिकवरेबल और बिल्स रिकवरेबल एक बार सर फिर से समझा दीजिए।
हेलो,
बिल्स रिकवरेबल इज ऑल द बिल्स व्हिच वी आर रेजिंग ऑन आउटसाइड एजेंसीज फॉर सर्विसेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द रेलवेज। ठीक है, हम लोग जो कुछ सर्विस उनको प्रोवाइड करते हैं, सर्विस किस तरह से प्रोवाइड करते हैं, इट कैन बी लैंड हमारा यूज किया होगा, हम लोगों ने उनको कोई सर्विस प्रोवाइड किया होगा थ्रू स्टाफ उनको दिया होगा काम कराने के लिए उनका काम। तो ऑल दीज बिल्स आर रेज्ड, बट सर्टन bills which we raise will contribute to demands recovery. That means it will go to traffic accounts as earnings. वो रहेगा, land license रहेगा, LC gates रहेगा, वो ऐसा कुछ रहेगा। Okay, interest and maintenance charges on sidings उसका classification, वो पूरा rent on buildings रहेगा। So, इसके ऊपर पूरा जो हमको इनकम आएगा दैट वी आर ट्रांसफरिंग टू ट्रैफिक अकाउंट्स सन्ड्री अर्निंग्स। बट सर्टेन ट्रांजैक्शंस जिसका हम लोगों ने बिल्स रेज किया है, लाइक स्टाफ कॉस्ट, ठीक है, स्टाफ कॉस्ट होगा वो रिडक्शन इन एक्सपेंडिचर होगा, मतलब उसको अर्निंग्स में नहीं डालना। हमारा एक्सपेंडिचर जो हम लोगों ने स्टाफ कॉस्ट दिया था पहले, जो मतलब सैलरी दिया था स्टाफ को, और बाद में हम लोग साइडिंग से जो बिल रेज करके क्लियरेंस करा रहे हैं, सो दैट विल गिव क्रेडिट टू आवर फाइनल हेड्स ऑफ एक्सपेंडिचर।
सर,
रिजर्व बैंक सस्पेंस के बारे में थोड़ा सा बताइए सर।
अब उसमें मैंने लिखा है इंग्लिश में, थोड़ा देख लो।
हेलो सर,
हाँ,
मोबिलाइजेशन एडवांस क्या होता है?
सम एडवांस इज गिवन टू कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स बेस्ड ऑन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कंडीशंस। सपोज वन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट हैज बीन गिवन, कॉन्ट्रैक्ट अवार्ड हुआ है टू कंस्ट्रक्ट वन एसेट फॉर द रेलवेज, लाइक अ वर्कशॉप, एक वर्कशॉप बनवा के देना है हम,
ठीक है जी सर।
तो उसके लिए उसको मैं मशीनरी ज्यादा खर्चा होगा कॉन्ट्रैक्टर का।
यस यस।
तो उसके लिए हम लोग क्या करते हैं, उसको एक मोबिलाइजेशन टू स्टार्ट ऑफ हिज बिजनेस ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्टर।